Hi friends, here Ravi. I welcome you to all to my YouTube channel Ravi Tech Studio. If you want to be the part of aeronautical industry, aerospace engineering industry, civil engineering industry, as well as automobile industry, then this is the right place to gain knowledge of the available opportunities and the courses which are required to become a professional, particularly in this four domain. As we know that all these domains, particularly if you talk about aerospace, aeronautical, automobile and civil engineering, these are all multidisciplinary industry where the graduates from any one of these branches may be the part of job sector, particularly in this industry domain. A civil engineer can work with Boeing or Airbus, particularly in designing of the internal structure of the aircraft. Similarly, the aerospace engineers can work in automotive industry as well as in civil construction, particularly for designing the multi-story buildings. So whenever we are constructing a multi-story building, it requires a comprehensive flow analysis to understand the behavior of the airflow in the high speed flow regimes, how air interacts over the edges of the building, so that if more resistance is overcoming coming on the edges of the building, that can be overcome by doing some slight modification by providing some curved surfaces right all around the edges of the building. Similarly, whenever we are designing the automobile car or the tracks, right, every automotive parts are undergoing through the aerodynamic testing. That is much more needed nowadays. Prior to 1952, we were not too much bothering about fuel economy or specific fuel congestion. But later on, when this aerodynamic concept was devised, right, and a lot of testings were done, particularly from poor aircraft initially, so by getting information, people got motivated, right, to enhance the performance of every device. So particularly for the car, first time aerodynamic concept was applied in designing the cars in the way back 1975. So even automotive industry, it is much needed to do the aerodynamic testing of cars, right? Even railways nowadays, high speed trains are also being tested for aerodynamic testing. And for aerospace and aeronautical, it is one of the core subject as aerodynamics being offered to most of the engineers. And nowadays, major universities are offering aerodynamics as one of the core subjects, right, particularly for civil as well for mechanical students. So a lot of people are having confusion, particularly whenever I see they are a bit confused about aerospace and aeronautical term. In the broad sense, both terms looks like a same, right? But there is a very light differences between the work these engineers used to do. Particularly when we talk about the aeronautical engineers are basically dealing for design and development of the aircraft and allied systems. Whereas in other end, aerospace engineers are basically dealing with the design and development of the devices which are required for space exploration, particularly when we are designing the space shuttle for human space program. For that purpose, aerospace engineers are needed. But more or less, right, some part of that design of space shuttle is common, right, that can also be handled by the aeronautical engineer. So these are basically interconnected branches. Similarly, if you talk about the electrical systems, right, involved particularly either in aircraft or spacecraft or maybe in rockets, that will for that purpose, electrical engineers can also be the part of aviation industry. All right. Similarly, when we talk about the civil engineering, right, civil engineering students used to study in-depth subjects like structural engineering, particularly strength of materials and this application to the steel structures, thin walled structures and all. If you look at the aircraft, fuselage, if you go inside, if you look at this complete fuselage is made of the rings kind of structure that is called former and bulkhead. Those are thin walled structures, right? So if you want to do the structural analysis of such kind of structures, then we do require particularly specialist who knows the basic understanding of the behavior of thin wall structure for that. Civil engineers are also equally required in aviation sector. So I am saying that nowadays every industry is becoming multidisciplinary industry, right? Even the industry which was earlier was an IT sector, when our company, they are migrating towards, you know, the core manufacturing industry. So there is a huge demand in coming future for these kind of engineers. So if you are willing to be the part of such kind of, you know, progressive journey to understand the industry dynamics and how to gain the opportunity, then this is the right place to join with. So I again, you know, suggest you to join my YouTube channel so that you can be the part of the progressive journey of these multidisciplinary, you know, industry. So guys, see you all on board. Have a nice day. Good day.